Oh, I got a slide open. Yeah. Okay. Here we go again. One step ahead of the snow, which is coming later. Departing from Filer, Idaho. Squeak was playing little games this morning. He didn't really want to go. No. Hey, Squeak. Not bad right now. Temperature's sitting around zero. Yep.
In 1.25 miles, take the exit on the right to US 93 towards Sun Valley.
Jackpot, Nevada, first casino. Busy place in the springtime with snowbirds coming home. The campground at Cactus Peak gets full every night. $6.39 for diesel here. Whoa. Guess they don't want to sell very much. Well, about 90 miles south of Jackpot, we're coming into Wells, a truck stop town. Not a whole lot here, a whole bunch of gas stations, a couple of brothels. They're legal here. And the going south on 95, just going underneath I-80. If you go east on I-80, you come into West Wendover, that's in Nevada, and Wendover, that's in Utah. Amazing difference between the two parts of the town. The West Wendover side is a bustling place, all new homes and everything. You go on to the Utah side, and it's kind of like slums. That was where the crew for the Enola Gay trained out of during the coming up to the end of World War II. About 2 hours south of Wells, we come into the town of McGill. And trust me, there's not very much in between, other than a bunch of signs saying check your fuel, because the next fuel is a long way down the road. Anyway, McGill got its claim to fame with a copper smelter here. Belonged to the Kennecott Copper Company. The reason it was put in here was because water was available. The actual mines were about 35 miles to the southwest in a town called Ruth, but they railed the copper ore back here to McGill, where it could be smelted down into copper. As you can see, it's not very prosperous. lot of kind of minor shacks here. You can't really tell what's open and what's closed. Just a few miles south of McGill is the town of Ely. That's spelled E-L-Y. Don't call it Eli, or the locals will get unhappy with you. So it's Ely, Nevada. A little bit bigger than McGill, a little bit more prosperous. Or they have a couple of casinos there, a campground. It's a kind of a junction. One way you can go to, say, to Las Vegas, taking Highway 93. If you go the other way and take Highway 6 and 318, you get to Vegas the same way, only you save about 45 miles, so that's the way we go. The only downside to this, and it doesn't really matter which way you go, is you have to climb up over a fairly high pass, 7,000 plus feet. And those are the mountains in the distance that we end up going over. Summit 7316. Turning south onto Highway 318, going downhill from here. Be nice to get out of the high country once we get down to our stopping point in Lund. We're almost out of the snow. It can still snow here, but it's not going to be horrible. Little town. A lot of these towns in Nevada, they have a 25 mile an hour speed limit, so you get to have a good close look at them as you're driving through, and they monitor it pretty closely, so everybody obeys the speed limit. Miles south of Lund, and we're approaching our stop for the night. Going to make a left here into a gravel pit. Stayed here numerous times before. Works out very well. Just us and the cattle. We're going to call it a day, and we'll continue this later on.